2017 Nissan Rogue Sport. The cargo area, at 22.9 cubic feet behind the second Rogue, that's 16.4 cubic feet less than the Rogue, is average for this class. It held plenty of grocery bags, and it has a couple of nifty underfloor divide and hide compartments. The Rogue Sport in basic S trim and FWD starts at $22,615 with destination charges. The test vehicle was the top-level Rogue Sport SL AWD at north of $31,000, with heated leather seats, moonroof, NEV, heated steering wheel and heated outside mirrors. Driver assist equipment includes lane departure warning and prevention, blind spot information system, surround view cameras, rear cross traffic alert and automatic emergency braking. The interior seems nice enough, though the more you look the more you see little cost-cutting measures like the seat bottom sides that are clocked to save on bits and scraps of leather. Some of the controls seem cheap, like the small, shallow radio volume knob. The navigation does not seem to sync with the vehicle light controls to auto-dim for night driving, though there's a button to do that manually. This car makes just 141 horsepower and 147 pound-feet of torque at 4,400 revolutions per minute from its 2.0-liter 4. And it has a CVT. So the Sport moniker pertains to nothing performance-related, just its diminutive size and zippy color choices like Monarch Orange or Nitro Lime. But the car drives fine. It's nimble enough. Acceleration is sufficient to get you to the grocery store and back. The cabin is quiet. Steering is light but not lifeless, and a sport setting gives it a little more heft. If a subcompact crossover is your heart's desire, you've got many choices. The Rogue Sport is nice looking and not bad driving. You'd want to cross-shop it against the Honda HR-V, Mazda CX-3, Subaru Crosstrek, Kia Niro and Dacia only knows how many others, and our car comparison tool is a great way to do that.